Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.1, Problem 6. This is Section 5.1, Problem 6. It says, how much does Sue have to invest now at 9% simple interest to have $8,000 in 5 years? So, I'm going to use a simple interest formula because the problem mentions simple interest. And again, just using a little common sense, if you're going to have $8,000 at the end of the 5 years, you're going to have to invest somewhat less than $8,000 now, say $5,000 or $6,000, and it's going to grow to $8,000. So a lot of these you can kind of apply some degree of common sense to make an estimate. So if you get an answer of, say, $9,600, well, that must be wrong. If you invest $9,600 now and it goes to $8,000 in 5 years, that's something went wrong. So anyway, because it says simple interest, I'm going to use the simple interest formula, I equals PRT. Now, as you start plugging into this formula, you'll see that you have a problem. I know the R is 9%. Which is going to be 0.09. I know the T, the time in years, is 5 years. The problem is, I don't know the interest, and I also don't know the principal. And if I knew either one, I could get the answer in my head. Like if the interest was $1,000, then the principal must be $7,000. Or if the principal was $7,000, well, that's the answer right there. What do you have to put in now? So that's not going to work. I have two unknowns. That's bad. So if you remember, there was an alternate simple interest formula that we go over in class. It's on the formula sheet for the finance formulas. It is A, the final amount equals P times in parentheses 1 plus RT. This is an alternate simple interest formula that's based on this one. And now I have only one unknown, the P. I know the A. The A is the final amount. It's 8,000. I know the rate. I know the time. The only thing I don't know is the P. Now I can do it. So, A, the final amount is 8,000. P is unknown. Parentheses 1 plus R, the rate as a decimal. The rate as a decimal, 9%, goes in as 0.09 times T, the time in years. So the time in years is 5 years. And I have some parentheses in this problem. Again, any type of math, you need to do your work in parentheses first. So 8,000 equals P times. Now, in the parentheses, I have an addition and a multiplication. And even though the addition is written first, the multiplication has to be done first. That's just the rule. That please excuse my dear Aunt Sally process. The multiplication has to be done before the addition. So I'm going to have 1 plus 0.09 times 5 is 0.45. And now in the parentheses, I'm left with 1 plus 0.45. So I have 8,000 equals P times 1.45. Now, to get the P by itself, which is your goal, you want to know the principal, you need to divide away the 1.45 that's multiplied times the P. So we have 8,000 divided by 1.45 equals P. Now that's not a division that I can possibly do in my head. So with a calculator, I'm going to do 8,000 divide by 1.45 equals, and the calculator will tell me the answer right away. So 8,000 divided by 1.45 equals, and the calculator gives me the answer 5517.241379. That's a lot of decimals. I don't need that many decimals. Since this is money, I only want to go to two places after the decimal. So after the decimal, I have 0.241. So the one is not big enough to bump this up to 25 cents. So my answer is going to be 5,517.24. So what that means is if Sue invests $5,517.24 now, in 5 years she'll have the $8,000 that she needs.